Chapter 20. A warm wind set the four great oaks whispering above the clans. Thick with foliage now, they'd lost their leaf-bare starkness. After moons of going to gatherings, Crooked Jaw had learned the names and pelts of most of the other clans, and with the truce, he felt comfortable moving among them. Besides, the warmer weather had smoothed tempers. He followed his clanmates into the clearing, where they melted into the chattering flock of cats. Owlfur and Bright Sky joined a group of warriors who were comparing apprentices loudly.
"It's been a good batch in ThunderClan this year,"
Adderfang boasted. Crookedjaw watched as Brambleberry hailed the medicine cats gathered below the great rock.
"Feather Whisker!"
She greeted Goosefeather's apprentice first, touching her muzzle to his head before turning to the others. Otter Splash headed straight for Patchpelt, a ThunderClan warrior.
"Has Leopardfoot kitted yet?"
she asked. Seeing Otter Splash's round belly, Crookedjaw wondered if she wouldn't beat Leopardfoot to it. She hadn't moved to the nursery yet, but surely she had to be expecting kids. Even in New Leaf, no RiverClan cat got that fat. He stopped beside Oakheart.
"Why do she cats always put off going to the nursery till the last minute?"
Both Shimmerpelt and Lakeshine had waited a moon. Oakheart shrugged.
"You'd think they'd like lying around all day having fresh kill brought to them."
Paws scuffed the ground behind him. Crookedjaw smelled rainflowers scent.
"Has it occurred to you that they might enjoy helping their clan?"
she pointed out.
"Wouldn't you find it hard to give up being a warrior?"
Oakheart sniffed.
"I'm just glad I don't have to sleep in the nursery," he meowed. "I had to stick my paws in my ears last night. Sunkit and Frogkit were mewling their ears off."
"Hi, Poppydawn."
Crookedjaw nodded to a dark red ThunderClan she-cat as she passed.
"Are Sweetpaw, Rosepaw, and Thistlepaw here?"
"No,"
Poppydawn sighed.
"Thistlepaw's in trouble with Small Ear again."
Windflight, her mate, shook his head.
"Sweetpaw and Rosepaw stayed behind to cheer him up."
Crookedjaw purred.
"They sound loyal."
Poppydawn dipped her head as Crookedjaw praised her kits.
"They are,"
she meowed proudly. Tanglewhisker trotted past them.
"Mumblefoot,"
he called to the ThunderClan elder.
"Wait for me!"
Birdsong hurried after him as her mate greeted Mumblefoot and Whiteberry, a WindClan elder. Oakheart watched the old cats.
"They'd talk the night away if they could,"
he joked. He caught Crookedjaw's eye.
"So how does it feel to be a warrior instead of an apprentice at the gathering?"
Crookedjaw flicked his tail happily. He was the equal of any cat here.
"It feels great."
Willowpaw broke away from a knot of apprentices demonstrating their latest moves.
"Greatpaw can be such a show-off."
She glanced sharply back at her sister, who was twisting in the air like a salmon trying to climb a waterfall. Crookedjaw fizzed with mischief.
"Why don't you go and show them how she snores?"
"I'm not sure they're ready for that,"
Willowpaw returned, purring. Rainflower beckoned Oakheart.
"Have you met Talltail yet? He'll be WindClan's leader one day. You should get to know him."
As she led him away, Crookedjaw spotted Bluepaw. He hadn't seen her since the battle. His nose stung as he remembered the wounds she'd inflicted. Not bad for a ThunderClan cat. He padded toward her.
"You fought well."
She flattened her ears.
"I fight even better now that I'm a warrior. My name is Bluefur."
He broke into a purr.
"I've got my warrior name too."
"Crookedjaw?"
he purred.
"How did you guess?"
"Because your tail's still straight."
As she joked with him, he felt a prick of guilt. She had no idea that RiverClan planned to reclaim Sunning Rocks as soon as the moon had waned. He pushed away the thought. She was a rival, pure and simple. A yowl sounded from the great rock.
"Let the gathering begin."
Pine Star stood at the edge of the stone, moonlight gleaming in his pelt. Hailstar was silhouetted behind him with Heatherstar and Cedarstar. Crookedjaw was swept forward beside Bluefur as the clans crowded around the rock. Pinestar stepped back as Cedarstar took his place.
"New Leaf has brought prey and warmth, but also more kitty pets straying across the borders,"
the Shadow Clan leader announced. Otter Splash lifted her muzzle.
"They hide in their cozy nests, all Leaf Bear, and forget that the woods are ours,"
she agreed.
"Just like two legs,"
Crookedjaw sighed. The field downriver was already filling up with their pelt dens. The ThunderClan leader stepped forward.
We intend to increase patrols, he glared at Hailstar, to warn off any intruders.
Did he know about RiverClan's plan to reset the boundaries? Growls rumbled uncertainly among the RiverClan cats. Raggedpelt, ShadowClan's deputy, responded first.
No ShadowClan cat has crossed your border in moons,
Hawkheart called from the cluster of medicine cats.
WindClan has stayed to our side of Four Trees, Hailstar's hackles lifted.
Are you accusing RiverClan of crossing your scent line?
Crookedjaw lashed his tail. In less than a moon, it would be RiverClan's scent line. Pinestar shrugged.
I'm not accusing any cat of anything, but ThunderClan will be stepping up patrols from now on.
He flexed his claws.
Better safe than sorry.
Why was Pinestar stirring up trouble at such a peaceful gathering? Crookedjaw felt Bluefur stiffen beside him.
Why start accusing the clans of trespassing? He called. We were talking about kitty pets.
Oakheart's growl sounded behind him.
ThunderClan cats always were a bunch of kitty pet friends.
Adderfang whipped his head around, eyes blazing.
Who are you calling kitty pet friends?
Oakheart met the ThunderClan warrior's gaze steadily.
Have you got something to say, fish breath?
Heatherstar called from the great rock.
In the name of StarClan, stop!
She looked up at the wisps of cloud streaking Silverpelt. Some of the stars were already hidden. Muttering, the clans fell into a prickly silence. The WindClan leader raised her muzzle.
Kitty pets rarely reach our borders,
Talltale called from below.
They're too slow to chase rabbits anyway.
And squirrels,
Small Ear added. Murmurs of agreement rippled through the clans, but pelts were still ruffled. Crookedjaw felt Bluefur shift her paws.
ThunderClan must suspect that we're planning something.
He was relieved when Hailstar padded to the front of Great Rock again.
Enough of kitty pets, he yelled. RiverClan has a new warrior,
he nodded to his clan.
Crookedjaw.
Crookedjaw looked up. He'd forgotten he was going to be introduced formally to the clans. He puffed out his chest as the clans chanted his warrior name and joined in to welcome Bluefur as Pinestar called out hers. But the cheers were half-hearted. The warmth of the gathering had evaporated, and it broke up in frosty silence. Crookedjaw joined his clanmates milling at the bottom of the slope. He paced around his brother while Tanglewhisker and Birdsong caught up.
Do you think Pinestar suspects we're going to take back Sunning Rocks?
Oakheart narrowed his eyes.
He was acting strange, but how could he know?
Perhaps Goosefeathers had a sign?
Shellheart cut in.
Pinestar's a wily old cat, he murmured. He's up to something, but no cat's crossed his borders. He's just stirring up trouble for his own reasons.
What did Bluefur say?
Oakheart asked.
Bluefur? Why did he want to know about Bluefur?
You were talking to her, Oakheart shrugged. I just wondered if she gave anything away.
No.
Didn't you feel weird talking to her knowing we're planning an attack?
Oakheart prompted.
My loyalty's to RiverClan, not Bluefur.
I guess, Oakheart's eyes darkened. But I kind of felt sorry for her.
Crookedjaw bristled.
Don't be soft on our enemies.
He felt a rush of pride.
I hope Mapleshade's listening.
As they approached camp, Crookedjaw guessed that something was wrong. They usually returned from gatherings to a sleeping camp. But tonight, anxious mews sounded from beyond the reeds. A shadow moved on the path.
Have you seen Beetlenose and Voleclaw?
Petaldust was pacing outside the camp.
Why? What's wrong?
Hailstar pulled up sharply, the patrol stumbling to a halt around him. Petaldust looked frantic.
They went to fetch you!
Hailstar shook his head.
We came back by the waterfall.
He turned and nodded to Shellheart and Owlfur.
Go and find them before they run into a ThunderClan patrol. After tonight's speech, Pinestar will shred them if he catches them on ThunderClan territory, truce or no truce.
As Shellheart and Owlfur dashed away, Brambleberry pushed through the entrance to the clearing.
Is it the kids?
She called. Crookedjaw raced after her. Mudfur was pacing in front of the nursery. Echo Mist and Softwing were huddled near him in urgent, whispered conversation.
You're back.
Echo Mist leaped to her paws. Troutclaw sat bleary-eyed at the bottom of the slope.
So much fuss over a kidding.
Brambleberry's ears twitched.
Shimmerpelt's kidding already?
Echo Mist circled the medicine cat. She started just before Moonhigh. Lakeshine and Piketooth are with her. The pale she-cat shook her head. It's too early, isn't it?
Brambleberry didn't answer.
Has there been any bleeding?
She asked calmly.
No.
Good.
Brambleberry padded past her toward the nursery.
Do you need herbs?
Echo Mist called after her. Brambleberry shook her head.
Only StarClan can help her, I'm afraid.
She hopped into the round reed den.
I hope she's all right.
Willowpaw was pacing around Softwing. Lakeshine popped her head out of the nursery.
She needs water.
I'll get it.
Willowpaw dashed to the reed bed. Bright Sky raced to join her, and together they pulled up a clump of dripping moss from the river's edge. They carried it back to the nursery and passed it to Lakeshine, waiting at the entrance.
I need honey,
Brambleberry called from the nursery.
Okay,
Birdsong headed for the medicine den. Crookedjaw exchanged glances with Oakheart as Willowpaw passed him, her jaw dripping with another mouthful of moss.
Honey?
It'll give her energy.
Willowpaw's mew was so muffled he could hardly make out her words. Crookedjaw turned to Oakheart, feeling helpless.
We could start collecting bulrushes to make a training wall for the kits, he suggested.
Oakheart purred.
It's a bit early for that.
There must be something we can do.
Timberfur caught his eye.
The warrior code doesn't cover kidding, he meowed sympathetically. We can just wait and hope.
Unless you want to go in and help,
Rippleclaw muttered. Crookedjaw shuddered.
No thanks.
Paws sounded outside camp and Shellheart ducked through the entrance, leading Owlfur, Beetlenose, and Voleclaw.
They made it to Four Trees and back without meeting anyone.
Crookedjaw's whiskers twitched.
You should work on your tracking skills, Beetlenose.
Finding cats is different from finding prey, Beetlenose sniffed. Cats are smarter than prey. At least some are.
How's she doing?
Echo Mist called into the nursery. A low groan answered.
She'll be fine,
Brambleberry yowled.
Where's that honey?
Coming!
Birdsong was trotting stiffly across the clearing, a lump of honeycomb oozing between her jaws. Beetlenose flicked his tail.
Hey, Crookedjaw, why don't you help Brambleberry deliver the kits? You always like to be the center of attention.
Why don't you?
Crookedjaw retorted. Beetlenose wrinkled his nose.
I'm a warrior, not a medicine cat.
Willowpaw wove between them.
Why are you so squeamish?
She chided.
Every cat has kits sometime.
Voleclaw stared at her.
I won't.
Beetlenose walked in a circle around Willowpaw.
You just want to have kits with Crookedjaw,
he taunted. Crookedjaw nudged the black warrior away indignantly.
That's not true.
A mule sounded from the nursery. Lakeshine slid out.
Two kits!
Her eyes shone in the moonlight.
A Tom and a she-kit!
Come on, Crookedjaw!
Willowpaw raced for the nursery. Reluctantly, he followed, sensing Beetlenose's mocking gaze. Brambleberry's face showed in the entrance.
Can we see them?
Willowpaw begged.
Okay, but you can't stay long and don't lick them. They're still getting used to their mother.
Willowpaw squeezed inside.
Come on.
Brambleberry motioned Crookedjaw in with a flick of her muzzle. She rolled her eyes.
Toms,
she sighed.
It's no scarier than a battle, I promise.
Crookedjaw heaved himself through the entrance, suddenly aware of how much he'd grown. It was hard to believe he was ever small enough to hop in and out of the nursery without effort. Inside, it was stifling. The air was dark and heavy with a strange scent. He could hardly see Shimmerpelt's crow-black pelt in the shadows, but the mewling of tiny kits filled his ears.
Look!
Piketooth was crouching beside Shimmerpelt, his eyes shining.
There are new denmates.
Frogkit was peering proudly over the side of his nest.
We're going to be the first ones to play with them ever!
Sunkit squeaked beside him. Willowpaw was staring into Shimmerpelt's nest. Crookedjaw peered in nervously. Two tiny kits wriggled against Shimmerpelt's belly. One was as brown as her father. The other had a black pelt as smoky as mist on the river at night.
Here are Black Kit and Sky Kit,
Shimmerpelt murmured. Sky Kit raised her muzzle, eyes closed, pink mouth opening to cry. She looked so tiny and helpless. Crookedjaw wanted to wrap his tail around her. Willowpaw pressed against him, purring.
Welcome to RiverClan, kits.
Crookedjaw shifted his paws.
They are kind of cute, he muttered grudgingly.
Will I have my own one day?
Is that part of my destiny? No, he sighed. Mapleshade would tell me I'm putting myself ahead of my clan.
Crooked Jaw curled wearily into his nest. White Fang was already snoring. Oakheart was giving his paws a final wash. Crooked Jaw tucked his paw under his nose and closed his eyes. He was desperate for sleep, but he couldn't relax. What if Mapleshade had seen him mooning over the kits with Willow Paw? She'd claw him for sure. He could imagine her hissing that he was a warrior, not a queen, that he should be out hunting for his clan, not huddled in the nursery imagining what it'd be like to sit next to Willow Paw as she cared for their kits. He pushed away the thought.
I'm doing it again. The clan comes first. The clan comes first.
But why did that mean he couldn't dream of having a mate and kits? The clan needed kits. Kits became warriors, and his kits would be strong and brave. Why couldn't he like Willow Paw?
I'm allowed to be friends with my clanmates. More than friends if I want. It can't hurt the clan.
His pelt shivered with indignation. How dare Mapleshade tell him how to feel?
Are you okay?
Oakheart prodded him with a paw. Crookedjaw kept his nose tucked under his paw.
Fine.
Stop fidgeting then, Oakheart complained. Some of us are trying to sleep.
Slowing his thoughts, Crookedjaw felt himself drift toward sleep. When he blinked open his eyes, sunshine was streaming through the entrance to the den. He hadn't dreamed of Mapleshade. He sat up, a purr rising in his throat.
What are you so cheerful about?
Oakheart was stretching in his nest.
Have you been dreaming about Willow Paw?
Crookedjaw hopped out of his nest, flicking Oakheart's ear with his tail as he passed.
Actually, I didn't dream at all.
Perhaps he'd scared Mapleshade by telling her off before he went to sleep. It felt good to wake up with no scratches or aching muscles. He hadn't felt so rested in moons. Shellheart was already organizing patrols beneath the willow when Crookedjaw padded out of the den. The RiverClan deputy beckoned him with a flick of his muzzle. Crookedjaw crossed the sunny clearing and nosed his way between Timberfur and Bright Sky. Owlfur and Cedarpelt were fidgeting, eager to be out on such a fine morning. Mudfur was still yawning while Voleclaw picked mud from between his claws. Beetlenose was watching the tip of Petaldust's tail flick back and forth, his eyes bright. Crookedjaw could tell he was fighting back the urge to pounce on it. He scanned the camp for Willowpaw, pricking his ears. Gentle snoring was coming from the apprentice's den. Graypaw and Willowpaw were probably worn out after the gathering, and then the excitement of Shimmerpelt's kidding.
Otter Splash moved to the nursery this morning, Shellheart announced, which means we're another warrior down. But the river's full of fish and still deep enough to keep the other clans at bay.
Unless they've learned to fly,
Voleclaw joked. Petaldust stifled a purr.
Wind Clan is more likely to learn how to fly than to swim. They hate water more than Thunder Clan.
Crookedjaw, Shellheart nodded at his son. Take Oakheart, Mudfur, Bright Sky, and Voleclaw upstream, and check the two-leg bridge for Wind Clan scent. Timberfur will be leading a patrol to check the stepping stones for any trace of Thunder Clan.
I'm leading a patrol?
Crookedjaw clawed at the ground. And Crookedjaw? Crookedjaw snapped to attention as Shellheart went on.
Check the two-leg fence on your way back. See if that dog's been straying again.
As Crookedjaw headed away, Shellheart called after him.
Be careful. If we didn't manage to scare him last time, the dog may be out for revenge.
Crookedjaw poked his head into his den. Oakheart was cleaning stale moss from his nest.
Come on, we've got a mission.
He glanced at White Fang. The warrior was still sound asleep in his nest. His whiskers were twitching furiously, and he was chirruping like a nervous moorhen.
Should we wake him?
And ruin his dream?
Oakheart shook his head.
What's the mission?
He followed Crookedjaw outside.
We're checking the bridge.
Mudfur, Voleclaw, and Brightsky were already waiting by the entrance.
And the two-leg fence.
Graypaw was there too, flicking her tail.
Can Graypaw come with us?
Brightsky called.
Of course.
Crookedjaw fluffed out his fur with importance. He ducked through the gap in the reeds and set a fast pace along the grass path. The sound of paws thrumming behind him filled him with joy. The sun was shining and a warm breeze wafted across the sparkling river. Crookedjaw had to fight to keep himself from purring out loud. He He veered off the path, following the trail up through the alders and doubling back around the camp, keeping up the pace until the patrol swerved back down to meet the river again. The shore was sandy on the edge of the marsh and soft on his paws. His pads sprayed dirt behind him as he slowed, and the patrol fanned out around him. Walking now, Crooked Jaw led the way upstream. Graypaw scampered through the shallows.
Can we fish?
Okart shrugged. If you want to carry what you catch for the rest of the morning. Graypaw sighed.
We could eat it now,
she mewed hopefully.
Just a little minnow wouldn't be breaking the warrior code, would it?
Yes, it would, Mudfur answered sternly. Besides, we should check the bridge, then look for the dog. Graypaw bounded ahead, her tail swishing. As they rounded a bend in the river, Crookedjaw glimpsed the two-leg bridge. Trees crowded the bank beyond it, their leaves whispered in the breeze. They could fish from there and eat, shaded from the hot sun.
Wait!
He signaled to the patrol with his tail and called Graypaw back. They were approaching the path that crossed the bridge.
Can anyone detect two legs?
Bright Sky was already tasting the air.
The wind's blowing upstream.
Mudfur pricked his ears.
I can't hear anything.
Crooked Jaw stalked forward, keeping low.
Follow me.
He crept up the bank where the legs of the bridge dug into the shore and padded onto the wooden pathway. The river splashed beneath as he sniffed the warm timber. His clanmates crept after him, padding from side to side of the bridge and checking for scents.
Come back!
Bright Sky's alarmed call made Crooked Jaw look up. Graypaw had crossed the bridge and was sniffing the bank on the far side.
But it's our territory,
Graypaw called back.
Right up to the waterfall.
A growl rumbled in Bright Sky's throat.
I don't know why Fallowtail didn't raise that kit to do as she's told.
Mudfur purred. Apprentices never do as they're told. His eyes sparkled as he glanced at Crookedjaw. Do they? Crookedjaw whisked his tail.
Only fish brains follow rules without question.
With a lurch, he suddenly realized that Oakheart had dropped into a crouch and was growling.
What?
Crookedjaw followed his brother's gaze and felt his hackles lift. A flash of white showed between the trees on the other shore, then a flash of red, then green and blue.
Two legs!
Crookedjaw froze, heart racing. Two-leg kits were scampering between the trees on the other side of the bridge, only a few tail lengths from Graypaw. Bright Sky had already darted forward, hissing to her apprentice.
Run!
Graypaw was staring at the two-leg kits, her fur bushed up, eyes glittering.
Run!
Mudfur yelled. The kits turned. With a whoop, they spotted Graypaw. Crookedjaw's heart rose in his throat.
Run!
The dumb paw was rooted to the spot. Crookedjaw charged forward, darting past Bright Sky.
Come on!
The bridge trembled as she dashed after him. One of the two-leg kits was holding out a paw. Graypaw stared at it, stiff with terror. Crookedjaw raced between the two-leg kit's paws, spitting with fury. The two-leg yelped and hopped away. Bright Sky raced past Graypaw, grasping her scruff and dragging her along until the apprentice squealed and struggled free.
Run!
Bright Sky yelled. Shaken from her moment of terror, Graypaw hurtled back across the bridge. Bright Sky pelted after her. Crookedjaw ducked back past the two-leg. With a jolt of horror, he felt its paws grasp his pelt. Struggling wildly, he broke free, yowling with pain as the two-leg ripped out a clump of fur. His paws slipped on the wood as he hit the bridge. Unsheathing his claws, he dug them deep and pushed hard. He crossed the bridge in two breaths.
Come on!
He called to his patrol as he raced past them. Glancing over his shoulder, he made sure his clanmates were following, then leaped onto the shore. He slowed to let them pass and fell in behind as they raced downstream. There was no way he was going to let any of them out of his sight till they were back in the safety of camp. The cries of the two-leg kits faded as they neared camp. Spotting the reed bed, Crookedjaw slowed. His lungs were splitting. He slowed to a stop and hung his head, gulping air. Bright Sky pulled up too, alongside Oakheart and Mudfur. Graypaw kept running until she reached the reed bed, and she plunged in, splashing through the river as she pushed her way home. Bright Sky watched her go.
Don't worry, she mewed. She's a strong swimmer.
Crookedjaw nodded, too winded to speak. Oakheart was still bristling and Mudfur paced, catching his breath and letting his pelt smooth. As they slowly recovered, paw steps sounded beside the shore. Crookedjaw looked up the bank as Graypaw led Hailstar and Echo Mist out of the marsh grass. Hailstar's fur was pricking.
Graypaw told us what happened.
Fallowtail pressed her cheek to Crookedjaw's.
Thank you for saving my kit, she whispered.
Crookedjaw twitched.
She could have done more to save herself, he muttered as he followed the she-cat into the clearing.
It looked like the whole clan was waiting for them, their eyes bright with worry. Graypaw had clearly told them about her near capture.
Why can't two legs stay on their own territory? Troutclaw protested. When I was a kit, we hardly ever saw one. Now they're here every green leaf making a nuisance of themselves.
Hailstar shook his head.
It's just the way it is, he sighed. We must be more cautious.
Echo Mist wrapped her tail over Graypaw. Perhaps we should shrink our borders just while the two legs are around?
Shrink our borders?
White Fang was awake now and spitting with anger.
Why should we? We're not scared of two legs.
Crookedjaw paced beside the reed bed, lashing his tail.
I'm not scared of anything that threatens my clan.
Chapter 21
Brambleberry!
Mudfur yowled as he hurried past the reed bed. Crookedjaw hauled himself out of the river, water streaming from his pelt. He tipped his head on one side. The brown warrior's call had been edged with worry. Brambleberry poked her head out of her den.
Is Bright Sky still uncomfortable?
Mudfur's tail trembled.
She keeps saying she's thirsty, and then she won't drink.
Brambleberry ducked back into her den.
Wait there.
Crookedjaw knew they were worried about Bright Sky. She'd moved to the nursery half a moon ago, expecting Mudfur's kits. But fever had struck, and she'd been sick for days. Crookedjaw picked his way across camp. The clearing was littered with his clanmates stretched out in the bright sunshine, too sleepy to move. It was pointless hunting with the sun so high. It was too hot to eat, and any fish caught now would be stinking by evening. Even the reeds were drooping under the scorching greenleaf sun. Crookedjaw hopped over Rippleclaw, who was fast asleep, and landed beside Graypaw. The gray apprentice was huddled in the shade of the fallen tree.
Where's Willowpaw?
She's out training with Alfer.
Graypaw gazed wistfully at the nursery.
I shouldn't have crossed the bridge.
She tucked her tail tighter.
Then Bright Sky wouldn't have had to rescue me.
That didn't make her ill, Crookedjaw reassured her. She knew she was expecting kits. It was her choice to carry on with her warrior duties as long as possible.
Why didn't she tell me?
Graypaw sighed.
I would have come back when she told me.
Are you sure? Crookedjaw bit his tongue, remembering his own days as an apprentice. When are her kits due?
Clawmoon?
That soon? Crookedjaw was surprised. It was only a few days away.
She'll be fine,
he meowed. Rippleclaw lifted his head and looked at Graypaw, sympathy lighting his gaze.
Are you still worrying about Bright Sky?
He got sleepily to his paws.
Can't Piketooth take you training?
Piketooth had been made Graypaw's mentor when Bright Sky had moved to the nursery.
It'll take your mind off things.
Rippleclaw glanced across the clearing to where Piketooth and Voleclaw were playing moss ball with Sunkit and Frogkit.
I could teach you some moves while he's busy.
Graypaw blinked gratefully at the black and silver warrior.
Yes, please.
Rippleclaw led Graypaw to a shaded spot at the edge of the clearing and started showing her a battle crouch. The sedge rustled as Brambleberry nosed her way from her den. With a bundle of herbs clasped in her jaws, she led Mudfur across the clearing and into the nursery. Crookedjaw closed his eyes.
Please, Star Clan, make Bright Sky healthy again.
A bundle of dark gray fur darted between his paws and pressed against his belly.
Hide me!
Black Kit squeaked.
Don't tell them where I am!
Crookedjaw stifled a purr and drew his forepaws closer together. Sky Kit was leading the search party. Otter Splash's kits, less than half a moon old, were following her as though she were clan leader.
Can you see him?
Loud Kit mewed, his dark brown pelt pricking.
What if he fell in the river?
Reed Kit fretted.
Don't be silly!
Sedge Kit rolled her eyes at her brother.
The warriors would be rushing around flapping like herons if he'd fallen in the river.
He's not here!
Sky Kit sniffed her way around the sedge wall.
Wait!
Loud Kit tasted the air.
I can smell him.
Where?
Reed Kit fluffed out his long, stiff tail. He darted past Sky Kit, nose to the ground, and sniffed his way between the lounging warriors, heading for Crookedjaw.
Watch out,
Crookedjaw whispered to the wriggling bundle beneath his belly.
I think they've found you.
He jumped out of the way as the Kit Patrol launched itself at him. They dived onto Black Kit, squeaking with triumph.
Found you,
Loud Kit crowed.
No, it's my turn to hide,
Sedge Kit squeaked. Sky Kit flicked her brown tabby tail.
I want to play something different.
She glanced at Pike Tooth. He tossed the moss ball high over Sun Kit's and Frog Kit's heads. They leaped to reach it, but Volclaw raised a paw and plucked it from the air.
I want to play that.
Sky Kit scampered away, her patrol following. White Fang grumbled as they clambered over him, and Trout Claw opened an eye and flicked his tail out of the way.
Star Clan bless them.
Birdsong dragged her gaze from the kits and called to Crookedjaw.
Is Shellheart back yet?
Shellheart was leading Beetlenose, Petaldust, Cedarpelt, and Timberfur on border patrol. They'd been out since sunhigh.
Not yet, Crookedjaw shrugged. They'll be back soon unless they've found somewhere shady to rest.
I don't know why they bother, Troutclaw sat up. There's hardly any border left for them to patrol.
White Fang heaved himself to his paws and shook out his white pelt.
Has Hailstar decided when we will remark Sunning Rocks?
He glanced toward the leader's den, hidden in shade under the roots of the willow. Lakeshine lifted her gray and white head. She was lying beside the nursery with Shimmerpelt and Otter Splash.
It's too hot to talk about battles.
Willow leaves fluttered as Oakheart jumped down from the lowest branch.
It's never too hot to talk about battles.
He padded across the clearing.
Hailstar said Claw Moon, which is any day now.
He glanced up to the wide blue sky.
The moon was no more than a sliver of trout skin last night.
Rainflower stretched.
He isn't planning a battle, she reminded them. He just wants to restore the proper boundary.
Crookedjaw scratched an itch behind his ear.
I'm ready whenever Hailstar decides.
Piketooth looked up from his game with the kits.
I hope I'm in the patrol,
he meowed. Every warrior wanted a chance to leave his or her scent.
Me too,
Rippleclaw was adjusting Graypaw's crouch with a paw.
Just reach a little farther, he advised, and you'll have it perfect.
Piketooth glanced at his apprentice.
Sorry, Kits, game's over. I have to train Graypaw now.
Sun Kit's tail drooped. Frog Kit leaped onto Piketooth's tail.
Don't go.
Sedge Kit raced around him.
Can we come?
Loud Kit leaped on his sister, tumbling her to the ground.
You can't even swim.
Neither can you.
Sedge Kit pushed him off.
Stay away from the water.
Piketooth leaped over the squabbling kits, beckoning Graypaw with his tail.
Do you want to practice fishing?
He asked her as she followed him out of the camp. Crookedjaw leaned down to wash his damp belly. Tiny paws scurried toward him. A flurry of tails, paws, and noses battered his flank. Crookedjaw staggered dramatically and fell onto his side.
You've killed me,
he groaned as the kits swarmed over him. Paw steps padded into camp.
The patrol's back,
Sky Kit squeaked. Crookedjaw looked up to see Shellheart, Cedarpelt, Beetlenose, and Petaldust staring at him, whiskers twitching with amusement.
Has Lakeshine made you leader of the nursery? Shellheart teased.
Crookedjaw jumped to his paws, wincing as Sky Kit and Frog Kit stuck in their claws and hung on like burrs.
Sorry, Crookedjaw, Cedarpelt purred. I forgot to teach you how to fight off kits.
Let me help.
Beetlenose rolled a clump of moss between his paws and tossed it across the clearing. The kits squeaked with delight and darted after it like a shoal of minnows.
Thanks.
As Crookedjaw followed Shellheart into the shade of the willow, the branches at the entrance to Hailstar's den shivered.
You're back.
Hailstar padded into the clearing, his pelt shining in the sun.
Let all cats old enough to swim gather to hear my words.
Loud Kit, Sedge Kit, Reed Kit,
Otter Splash called to her kits.
Come out of the way.
Dragging their paws, the kits headed toward their mother.
And you too,
Shimmerpelt called to Sky Kit and Black Kit. Frog Kit and Sun Kit ducked behind Beetlenose, but the Black Warrior nosed them toward the nursery.
But we can swim,
Frog Kit complained.
Really?
Beetlenose picked Frog Kit up by his scruff and dangled him over the edge of the river. Lakeshine jumped to her paws.
No! She shrilled. Put him down! He'll drown!
Beetlenose purred.
Don't panic.
He dropped the wriggling kit at his mother's paws.
I'll teach you to swim as soon as your mother says you're ready, he promised.
I'd rather be taught to swim by a snake,
Crooked Jaw muttered as Oakheart joined him at the edge of the clearing. Oakheart didn't answer. His attention was fixed on Hailstar.
I bet he's going to announce the retaking of Sunning Rocks.
Crooked Jaw flexed his claws.
Good.
Timberfur paced the edge of the clearing.
At least you already know you'll be part of the patrol.
Hailstar waited for the clan to settle, then lifted his muzzle.
We remark the Sunning Rocks boundary tonight.
Tension pricked the air. Oakheart leaned forward. Timberfur stopped pacing.
Who are you taking? Rippleclaw demanded.
Shellheart, Owlfur, Echomist, Timberfur, Softwing, and Rippleclaw, the RiverClan leader began.
And? Crookedjaw's heart quickened. Surely Hailstar would keep his promise. Oakheart tensed beside him.
Whitefang and Crookedjaw.
Crookedjaw swallowed a purr of relief.
Oakheart, Hailstar went on. And Volclaw.
He sat down and curled his tail over his paws.
Is that it?
Beetlenose lashed his tail. Hailstar turned his gaze on the young warrior.
The new boundary will need remarking for many moons to come, he reminded him. You'll get your turn to leave your scent soon enough.
Retaking an old boundary is not the same as marking an existing one.
Beetlenose glared at Crookedjaw.
Why does he get to go when he's been a warrior for less than a moon? He didn't even have an assessment. How do we know he can even climb the rocks?
Crookedjaw leaped forward, bristling.
I climbed Sunning Rocks when I was still an apprentice, he growled.
Shellheart stepped between them.
Not every warrior can be on every patrol, he soothed.
Beetlenose darted around Shellheart and squared up to Crookedjaw. Shellheart leaned close. It might be better for you to meet Beetlenose's disappointment with words rather than claws, he whispered in Crookedjaw's ear.
Crookedjaw narrowed his eyes. You must put your clan first.
Mapleshade's words rang in his ears. He smoothed his fur.
I'm lucky to have been chosen, he confessed. I'm sorry you won't be with us tonight, Beetlenose.
The words nearly stuck in his throat, but he forced them out for the sake of the clan. Rainflower was glowering beneath the willow. She hadn't been chosen either.
I wish I could have the whole clan beside me,
Crookedjaw nodded to Piketooth and Cedarpelt.
You taught me everything I know.
His paws pricked. He wasn't used to making speeches, but if he was going to be a leader one day, he'd better get used to it. He met Beetlenose's gaze.
And I learned lots just watching you train. Your courage gave me courage, and your skill sharpened mine.
Not as much as Mapleshade's.
He dipped his head low.
When I leave my mark tonight, I shall be leaving it in your honor.
He looked up, hoping desperately that his words had soothed his clanmates' ruffled pelts. Beetlenose's eyes glittered.
Okay,
he conceded. Oakheart padded past Crookedjaw and halted.
That's right, Crookedjaw, he purred. We are a clan, and when one cat fights, he fights for the whole clan.
Well said, son, Shellheart meowed.
Crookedjaw felt a surge of pride. Was that a glimmer of respect flashing in Rainflower's narrowed gaze? Hailstar flicked his tail.
We leave at Moonhigh.
As the gathering broke up, Crookedjaw headed for the nursery. Joy fizzed beneath his pelt. This would be his first warrior mission. But before he left, he had time to help out with some nursery duties. He called to the kits, sulking behind their mothers.
Who wants a game of Hunt the Frog?
The night heron spiraled up and whirled away downstream as the patrol padded onto the shore. Crookedjaw paused at the water's edge. The river flowed black and smooth past his paws, lit only by stars and the thinnest scratch of moon. Sunning Rock stood on the far bank, dark against a dark sky, timeless as high stones. Hailstar slid into the river. As the water closed silently over his back, his clanmates followed him in. Crookedjaw let the cool water wrap itself around him, relishing the chill after a long day's wait. Quieter than trout, the patrol swam the river, hardly disturbing the surface of the water. No ThunderClan lookout would have seen or heard them. They probably would be watching the stepping stones, alert for a flash of pelt or the sound of paws on stone. Crookedjaw pushed ahead with long, smooth kicks and reached the shore first. Here the river's edge was little more than a rock shelf jutting out below Sunning Rocks and dropping straight down to the bottom of the river. Crookedjaw pulled himself noiselessly from the water, hopping up onto the stone. Oakheart climbed out beside him while Hailstar and Whitefang waded onto the bank, a tail length downstream. Voleclaw flung a paw over the edge of the rock shelf and hauled himself out with Rippleclaw and Softwing on his tail. Echomist and Owlfur followed, and Shellheart brought up the rear. They stood dripping on the bank while Hailstar launched himself up the rock.
"Wait here," he hissed down. "I'll check for patrols."
Crookedjaw gazed up at the starlit sky. He remembered last time he was here, fighting Bluepaw and Snowpaw. This time he wasn't going to be chased from his own territory. Hailstar's head appeared over the top.
"All clear."
With a nod, Shellheart leaped up the sheer rock face. His clanmates swarmed after him. Crookedjaw followed, hooking himself up one claw hold at a time and landing easily on the smooth, flat stone. The rocks sparkled with starlight. Hailstar waved his tail toward the trees, crowding the far edge of Sunning Rocks. ThunderClan's territory, every last branch and twig.
"You begin that side, Shellheart," he nodded toward the top of the cliff. "Alfur, Softwing, Voleclaw, and Rippleclaw, join him." He glanced at the others. "You come with me."
As Crookedjaw followed the River Clan leader over the rock, he let the cool night air bathe his tongue. ThunderClan scent. His pelt pricked. Stale. They hadn't been here for days. He guessed glaring sun was too hot for cats used to forest shade. Hailstar sprayed the first tree they reached. Crookedjaw winced at the stench. It was strong enough for ThunderClan to smell long before they reached the tree line.
"I want every bush and tree sprayed," Hailstar ordered.
Crookedjaw crossed the narrow strip of grass and stopped beside a bramble. He marked it, growling.
"Smell that, ThunderClan."
By the time they met back at the cliff top, the forest was drenched in RiverClan scent.
"I want four warriors to stay," Hailstar announced. "If a ThunderClan patrol comes, challenge them. If there's a fight, we'll hear from the camp and send reinforcements."
Timberfur stepped forward.
"I'll stay." "Me too."
Crookedjaw lined up with him. Hailstar nudged him away.
"I want my most experienced warriors to take the first watch."
He glanced at Shellheart.
"You stay with Timberfur, Echomist, and Owlfur."
Crookedjaw itched with frustration as he followed Oakheart down the cliff face. He lowered himself, pawhold by pawhold, until he felt the ground brush his tail tip. Then he let himself drop and landed lightly beside Whitefang. The white warrior's eyes shone.
"That was as easy as swallowing a minnow."
Hailstar nodded.
"Let's go and tell the clan."
Their clanmates were waiting in the starlit clearing. Beetlenose paced beside the reed bed. Lilystem stared expectantly from beneath the willow. Even the queens had slid from the nursery and were lined up, their eyes filled with hope.
"Did you do it?"
Lakeshine called.
"Sunning Rocks belongs to River Clan again," Hailstar announced.
The clan's cheers sent roosting birds flapping into the still night air. Willowpaw hurried over to Crookedjaw.
"Did you have to fight?"
"It was easy," he told her. "There wasn't a single patrol."
Beetlenose snorted.
"That's because all of ThunderClan is asleep."
"They hadn't been there for days,"
Voleclaw added.
"It's too hot for their delicate forest paws,"
Petaldust crowed. Crookedjaw looked around at his jubilant clanmates. Was he the only cat who felt that this victory had been too easy?
"I can't believe they haven't tried to fight for it,"
Oakheart hauled himself onto the topmost boulder of Sunning Rocks.
"It's been 2 days. We'll be able to bring the elders up here soon to enjoy the warmth."
Crookedjaw followed his brother over the edge and surveyed the wide stretch of stone, white now beneath the fierce morning sun.
"They might still be waiting to catch us off guard."
He nodded to the RiverClan patrol they'd been sent to relieve. Petaldust and Cedarpelt flicked their tails in welcome. Beetlenose stretched while Mudfur hurried toward them.
"Bright Sky's doing fine.
Crookedjaw told the brown warrior. Had Hailstar hoped to distract Mudfur from Bright Sky's illness by sending him for guard duty? Clearly it hadn't worked. Mudfur was frowning as he disappeared over the edge of the rock, fast as a fish, and splashed into the river. Why hadn't StarClan healed Bright Sky by now? Fallowtail and Whitefang clambered onto the rocks as Beetlenose, Cedarpelt, and Petaldust began to climb down.
Mudfur was in a hurry,
Whitefang panted. Fallowtail sighed.
I just hope Bright Sky's fever breaks before her kits come,
she called after Petaldust.
Send word if there's any change. Even if it's bad news?
Petaldust's mew echoed up the rock.
Yes.
Beetlenose yowled from the foot of the cliff face.
Call if you need help.
Crookedjaw turned away.
We won't need help.
Not one marker had been replaced by ThunderClan scent in the 2 days since they'd set them. ThunderClan seemed to have given in without a fight. Crookedjaw padded across the rock and lay down on its hot, smooth surface. Oakheart sat beside him, staring into the woods while Fallowtail and Whitefang sniffed along the rim of the rock plateau. White clouds drifted across the sun, sending shadows over the rocks. Crookedjaw stretched, enjoying the sunshine and shade sweeping his pelt. Oakheart began washing.
I can't believe it was so easy,
Whitefang sounded as if he'd wanted a battle. Crookedjaw rolled over.
They may still make us fight for them.
Below them, bushes rustled at the tree line. Crookedjaw sat up, bristling.
Did you hear that?
Fallowtail tasted the air.
ThunderClan, she whispered.
The patrol was on its paws in a moment, hackles up, staring into the trees. Crookedjaw took a long breath, letting the air wash his tongue. There were definitely ThunderClan cats moving among the undergrowth, but not enough to make an attack patrol. He detected one familiar scent.
Blue fur.
Oakheart was already bounding down the rocks.
Careful,
Fallowtail warned. Crookedjaw shook his head.
They won't attack, he reassured her. It's just a border patrol.
Oakheart was peering through the trees, his ears pricked as though he'd spotted prey. Then Crookedjaw heard a vicious hiss and the yowl of a ThunderClan warrior calling to her clanmate.
Bluefur!
Oakheart turned away, pelt smooth, eyes glittering. Whitefang jumped down the rocks to meet him.
Did you see anything?
He called.
Just a young ThunderClan warrior being nosy.
Oakheart climbed back up the rocks and sat down to lick his paws.
Just a young warrior?
Crookedjaw remembered Oakheart talking about Bluefur at the gathering.
It was Bluefur, wasn't it?
Oakheart ran his wet paw over his ear.
So?
Was she upset about losing Sunning Rocks?
I guess so. Oakheart sniffed. I didn't ask. Why would I want to speak to a ThunderClan cat?
You seemed like you were really interested in finding out all about her after the last gathering.
His brother stopped washing.
It's not me who moons over she-cats,
Oakheart shot back.
You follow Willowpaw around like a kit following its mother.
Crookedjaw flushed.
I do not.
Oakheart nodded.
Yeah, right.
He sounded unconvinced. Crookedjaw narrowed his eyes and leaped on his brother.
I'm just helping her with her training.
Oakheart grabbed his shoulders and rolled him over.
That's one way of putting it.
They tussled, squawking on the warm rock.
Hey!
Fallowtail grabbed Crookedjaw's scruff and pulled him off.
We're supposed to be guarding our territory, she growled, not showing ThunderClan how we play fight.
Crookedjaw sat up, his fur ruffled.
Sorry.
Fallowtail,
Whitefang was calling from the forest's edge.
More ThunderClan warriors are coming!
He dropped into a crouch as Fallowtail, Oakheart, and Crookedjaw leaped down Sunning Rocks to join him. Crookedjaw squinted into the green shadows. He could see pelts flashing between the trunks. Anger flared in his chest. No ThunderClan cat was going to set a paw on his territory. Now that RiverClan had reclaimed it, he'd fight to the death to keep it. He curled his lip and hissed into the forest. The undergrowth swished, and the pelts melted away.
Fox hearts!
Crookedjaw felt power pulsing in his paws. He was ready to beat any cat who threatened his clan. Mapleshade was right. Being loyal to his clan felt better than anything else in the whole world. Chapter 22
Keep your tail down,
Crookedjaw pressed Willowpaw's tail to the ground and nudged her forepaws forward.
Reach as far as you can.
Oof!
The breath puffed out of Willowpaw as he adjusted her ribs, flattening them to the ground.
Now leap, Crookedjaw ordered.
Leap?
Willowpaw was splayed like a dead frog. She twisted her head around and stared at him.
I can hardly move.
Crookedjaw sat up.
I'm only trying to help.
The sun was rising over the trees on the far side of the river. Willowpaw's assessment was due to start any moment. She struggled to her paws.
Thanks,
she mewed, shaking out her legs.
But I'm not sure if you're cut out to be a mentor.
Don't say that!
Crookedjaw's pelt rippled with dismay. He really wanted to help her pass the first time.
I'm just trying to make you see how important it is to stay low if you're stalking birds.
Alpha won't make us stalk birds,
Willowpaw argued.
I'm training to be a River Clan warrior, not Thunder Clan.
When the river freezes, birds are all we can catch,
Crookedjaw reminded her.
But I've never caught a bird.
Willowpaw's eyes sparked with sudden panic.
You don't think he'll actually test me on that? Alpha only covered basic land hunting techniques. He doesn't like catching leaf bear prey when the river's full of fish. He said it was a waste.
She dropped back into a crouch.
Let's try again.
She flattened her tail and pressed her muzzle into the grass, then sat up, wailing.
I can't do it! I'm going to fail!
No, you're not.
Crookedjaw circled her, trying to remember what Mapleshade had taught him. His pads itched with frustration. Mapleshade had concentrated on battle moves. He thought harder. Had he caught birds with cedar pelt?
Oh, yes! I know!
He realized in a flash what was wrong with her crouch.
Your forepaws should be tucked under your shoulders, not stretched out. That way you'll get a better jump.
Willowpaw dropped again, drawing her paws beneath her.
That feels better.
With a sharp push, she shot forward and stretched up, skimming a clump of marsh grass.
Excellent!
Crookedjaw purred.
Willowpaw!
Graypaw's mew sounded from the other side of the reeds.
Alpha's ready!
Willowpaw's eyes stretched wide.
Oh, Star Clan!
Worry clouded her gaze.
I hope I pass. Hurry up,
Graypaw urged.
Piketooth started my assessment.
You'll be great,
Crookedpaw promised. But Willowpaw was already dashing away.
Good luck,
he called after her. As she disappeared into the rattling stalks, he headed for the river, too restless to go back to camp. It was too early to fish, but he could swim. It'd cool him down. He slid into the water and let it carry him downstream, rolling onto his back as he drifted past the camp. Through the reeds, he could see flashes of pelt and hear squeals as the kits charged across the clearing. He felt a prick of sadness. He remembered playing with oak kit and beetle kit, vole kit and petal kit. Things had changed so much since then. He pushed away the thought. He was a warrior now, and one day he'd be the greatest leader RiverClan had ever known. What more could he possibly want? He struck out and swam for the bank. Climbing out near the stepping stones, he could hear birdsong's mew drifting down from Sunning Rocks. Hailstar had decided it was safe for the elders to start visiting them again.
It's so good to feel the warmth of the stone on my pelt, she rasped.
Tanglewhisker answered, purring,
There's nothing like it for reaching every ache.
Crookedjaw padded up the shore and followed a narrow trail into the spindly trees. The sun was shining, but he could taste a change in the wind. It was scented with heather from the moors. Rain was on the way. The grass swished ahead of him. Crookedjaw froze. A pelt was moving between the trees, keeping low.
Alfer.
Crookedjaw crouched and held his breath as the brown and white warrior passed. He must be assessing Willowpaw. Was she nearby? Darting behind a trunk, he crouched down, out of sight. Paw steps scampered toward him. Crookedjaw's heart quickened as he waited for Willowpaw's pelt to come flashing past. But it was Graypaw heading toward the river, scowling with concentration. Crookedjaw hid as she passed, then pulled himself up the tree, straining to see over the grass. There! Willowpaw's pale tabby pelt was pushing through a clump of ferns. The feathery green fronds curled over and trailed along her spine. Her eyes were fixed on the ground. She must be stalking something.
A blackbird.
She padded closer as the bird struggled to pull a worm from the ground.
Pounce.
Crookedjaw willed her on, but Willowpaw was taking her time. She dropped into a crouch, flattening her tail, tucking her forepaws under her shoulders, and pressing her belly against the ground. Crookedjaw felt a flicker of pride.
I taught her that.
He tensed as the blackbird plucked the worm free.
Now!
Willow Paw leaped as the blackbird lifted into the air. With a deft paw, she hooked it and brought it plummeting to the ground. She held it fluttering beneath her forepaws and looked around hopefully. Alfer's head appeared from behind a bush.
Very good, he meowed. You can let it go.
Eyes shining, Willow Paw released the blackbird and it fled, squawking into the branches above her head.
Well done,
Crookedjaw's heart soared.
What in the name of Star Clan are you doing? A voice sounded from the bottom of the tree.
Guilt flooded his fur.
Maple Shade.
She'd caught him watching Willow Paw again. Crookedjaw whirled around, ready with an excuse, and saw Shellheart staring up at him, puzzled.
Why are you hiding in a tree?
Shellheart asked. Crookedjaw slithered headfirst down the trunk.
I was just seeing if the assessments were going okay.
He stammered to a halt. Shellheart's ears twitched.
Really?
He didn't sound convinced. Crookedjaw shrugged.
I wanted to see how Willow Paw was doing.
Shellheart looked at him with amusement.
I guessed,
he purred. And how is Willow Paw doing? Crookedjaw couldn't stifle his purr.
Great!
Good. Shellheart nosed him away from the tree.
Why don't you come back to camp with me? We don't want to distract her when she's doing so well.
He steered Crookedjaw onto a trail that led away from the apprentices. In the clearing, Mudfur was pacing outside the nursery.
Something's wrong.
Ottersplash trotted after the brown warrior, calling,
I'm sure she'll be fine. They'll all be fine.
Crookedjaw stopped and looked around. Echomist crouched beneath the willow, her anxious gaze fixed on the nursery. Rainflower growled softly to herself as she padded along the edge of the reeds. Crookedjaw blocked her path.
What's wrong?
Rainflower closed her eyes.
Bright Sky's kidding.
Why can't we go to the nursery?
Sunkit complained.
We just can't,
mewed Shimmerpelt, who was helping Lakeshine shoo the kits up the slope toward the elder's den.
But why not?
Come on, dears,
Birdsong called from the top.
Come and explore our nests. Have you been inside the elder's den before, Reed Kit?
I don't want to go in there.
Reed Kit stopped at the entrance.
It's stinky.
Shimmerpelt nudged him forward with her nose.
Don't be rude.
Loud Kit scowled.
It's too hot to be inside,
he complained.
Can't we practice swimming in the reed bed?
Lakeshine shook her head.
Later, little one. We just need to be quiet for a while.
A shriek sounded from the nursery. Sunkit bristled.
What was that?
Shimmerpelt nudged her inside.
Bright Sky's kidding.
Crookedjaw stared at Rainflower.
When did she start?
Just after dawn.
Rainflower's gaze was dark.
Brambleberry's worried. Bright Sky's still weak from fever.
But she's a tough warrior,
Crookedjaw pointed out.
Sometimes that's not enough,
Rainflower warned over her shoulder as she padded away. Crookedjaw joined Ottersplash and Mudfur.
Does Brambleberry need anything? Water? Honey?
Ottersplash halted.
She's tried all that, and raspberry leaf too.
She lowered her voice as Mudfur carried on walking.
Nothing's working.
Another long, desperate moan sounded in the nursery.
She's exhausted,
Ottersplash murmured. Birdsong dashed down the slope.
Trout Claw's keeping the kits busy playing Hunt the Tick.
Her eyes turned to the nursery.
How is she?
Ottersplash just shook her head.
I'm going inside.
Birdsong heaved her wide white belly through the nursery entrance and disappeared. Oakheart padded, yawning from his nest.
Is it over yet?
He caught Ottersplash's gaze and stopped. Birdsong slid out again. Her amber eyes were round and misted with grief.
Three kits,
her mew was husky.
All dead.
Mudfur was at her side in an instant.
And Bright Sky?
Birdsong stared at him blankly.
You'd better go in.
Mudfur lowered his head and turned toward the nursery. He stepped slowly inside, as if he had suddenly grown very old. A moment later, a low moan drifted through the reed wall. Crookedjaw stared at Birdsong.
Is she dead?
Birdsong nodded. Crookedjaw stared at the ground, not knowing what to say or do. Then a thin mule drifted across the clearing. Crookedjaw looked up. A kit? Brambleberry poked her head out.
There was a fourth,
she mewed quickly.
She's weak, but she's breathing.
She ducked back inside. Hailstar pushed his way out of his den and stood beside Echo Mist. He dipped his head.
Thanks, Star Clan, for this precious life.
Get Shimmerpelt, Birdsong told Crookedjaw. The kit will need warmth and milk.
Crookedjaw dashed up the slope and called into the elder's den.
Shimmerpelt!
She darted out at once.
Come with me.
Crookedjaw escorted her down the slope.
One kit survived. It'll need your milk.
Shimmerpelt stopped.
Survived?
Hurry up.
How's Bright Sky?
Shimmerpelt's gaze pierced him. Crookedjaw's paws froze. He stared at her.
Is she dead?
I'm sorry,
he burst out.
I should have warned you. I...
Shimmerpelt padded past him, silencing him with a flick of her tail.
It's okay,
she murmured.
It's okay.
Crookedjaw watched her pad to the nursery and disappear inside. A moment later, Mudfur squeezed out. He staggered blindly across the clearing. Timberfur hurried to his side and propped him up as he guided his denmate to a shady space under the willow. The grief-stricken warrior collapsed, muzzle on paws, staring into the distance. Timberfur crouched beside him as though sitting vigil, and Rippleclaw crossed the clearing to join them. Crookedjaw's heart twisted in his chest. The kits were streaming out of the elder's den, squealing as they chased one another down the slope. The reeds swished as Graypaw and Willowpaw charged into camp.
We passed!
Willowpaw's eyes shone.
We passed our assessment!
Graypaw paced around her sister, tail high.
Willowpaw caught a blackbird! And Graypaw caught the biggest trout Alfer's ever seen!
Willowpaw charged across the clearing to Crookedjaw.
Thank you, thank you!
She licked his cheek.
I did everything you told me. You should have seen me.
She paused and tilted her head to one side.
What's wrong?
She stepped away from Crookedjaw.
What's happened?
Rainflower looked up from the bottom of the slope.
Bright Sky died, she meowed. And three of her newborn kits.
Crookedjaw was surprised by the grief in his mother's gaze. He pressed his muzzle against Willowpaw's cheek.
I'm proud of you.
He whispered.
Little cats old enough to swim gather to hear my words,
Hailstar called from outside his den. Brambleberry stood beside the River Clan leader, back straight, fur smooth. Willowpaw's eyes glistened.
You'll be getting your warrior name,
Crookedjaw murmured. Willowpaw sighed.
I never imagined it would be like this.
She padded into the clearing as the clan gathered. Mudfur seemed unaware of what was happening and stayed beneath the willow. Timberfur and Rippleclaw didn't move from his side. The kits hung back beside the reed bed, quiet now. Even they realized something terrible had happened.
Bright Sky is dead,
Hailstar announced.
And three of her kits.
He waited for murmurs of grief to pass through the clan before he went on.
But one kit has survived.
He glanced at Mudfur.
She has not been named yet, but she will always be treasured by the clan. A reminder of a warrior worthy of Star Clan. We will make sure Bright Sky's kit grows up to honor and love her mother's memory.
He lifted his muzzle, his eyes fixing on Fallowtail.
River Clan never forgets the sacrifice of its queens. Fallowtail once sacrificed her kits so that the clan could live in peace. We are lucky to have them back, and I consider it a blessing from Star Clan that they have grown into such fine warriors.
He dipped his head.
Willowpaw, Graypaw, come forward.
As the apprentices padded into the clearing, Hailstar went on.
Willowpaw, you have the swiftness of a Wind Clan cat, but the heart of a River Clan warrior. In honor of your speed, courage, and cleverness, I give you the name Willow Breeze.
Crookedjaw lifted his voice, solemnly chanting the new warrior name with his clanmates. Clouds had covered the sun and were quickly darkening as Hailstar went on.
Graypaw, you have your mother's determination, bravery, and warmth. From this moment, you shall be known as Graypool.
Graypool! Graypool! Graypool!
As Crookedjaw lifted his muzzle to join in, a raindrop splashed on his nose. In a few moments, the storm broke and rain pounded the camp, as though StarClan itself was mourning for Bright Sky and her lost kits. Chapter 23 Crookedjaw padded, yawning, from his nest. Dawn was just starting to brighten the horizon. The river gurgled beyond the reeds and snores rumbled from the other dens as he nosed his way into the clearing. He'd noticed the clan had been sleeping more since the death of Bright Sky and her kits. They crawled later from their dens, their old enthusiasm for the day's duties drooping like sedge beneath a heavy frost.
Ow!
A squeak made him pause.
You're treading on my tail!
The sedge was rustling on the far side of camp. Crookedjaw strained to see through the half-light. A tiny tail was disappearing among the green fronds. He padded noiselessly across the clearing, pricking his ears.
Which way are we going?
I don't know.
He recognized the squabbling mews of Frogkit and Skykit.
Why didn't we just go out the entrance?
We might have been caught.
Crookedjaw plunged his head into the sedge and grabbed Frogkit by his scruff. Dragging him out, he dropped him on the ground and reached in for Skykit.
Hey!
She struggled as he pulled her out of the stalks.
Where are you going?
He asked sternly, depositing Skykit beside her denmate. The two kits exchanged glances. Crookedjaw guessed they were working out whether to tell the truth or not. Fur brushed the sedge wall behind him.
Brambleberry.
She was yawning.
I was just heading out to fetch herbs,
she mewed sleepily.
I'm glad you're here, Crookedjaw greeted her. I caught these two trying to sneak out of camp.
Brambleberry's whiskers twitched.
What? Kits? Trying to sneak out? That's never happened before.
She stared in mock surprise at Crookedjaw. Crookedjaw swallowed back a purr. He was trying to stay stern for the kit's sake. Besides, he knew better than any cat the dangers waiting beyond the camp wall for adventurous kits.
Where are you going?
He asked them again. Frogkit glanced at Brambleberry, then at his paws.
We wanted to see where Bright Sky's kits were buried,
he mumbled. Brambleberry frowned.
Why in the name of StarClan would you want to do that?
Skykit shuffled her paws.
We wanted to see if it was true they were dead.
Crookedjaw leaned closer.
Why wouldn't it be true?
StarClan doesn't really let kits die, does it?
The kit's pale brown fur rippled. Frogkit twitched his striped tail.
Ottersplash wouldn't let us see the vigil.
Crookedjaw tucked his tail tight over his paws as he remembered the long, heartbreaking night. Less than half a moon ago, when Mudfur had chased his clanmates away from Bright Sky's body and cradled his three dead kits against his mate's stiff flank.
StarClan does take kits,
Brambleberry told them,
and keeps them safe.
She crouched beside the wide-eyed kits.
They'll be allowed to hunt there. StarClan has the clearest rivers and fastest fish, and they'll be with Bright Sky.
Frogkit stuck out his tail.
Birdsong says StarClan took them as an omen. Rainflower and Echo Mist say that more bad things are going to happen,
Skykit added. Frogkit went on.
Piketooth thinks StarClan is angry with us, and Troutclaw says that's why you couldn't save the kits or Bright Sky.
Brambleberry flinched.
It wasn't an omen,
her mew was steady.
Sometimes bad things happen. I did everything I could, but Bright Sky was too sick, and it made her kit sick, too.
Crookedjaw drew closer to the medicine cat.
If StarClan was angry with us, why did they leave us Leopard Kit?
He reminded the kits. Mudfur had named his daughter after the ancient clan, hoping it would give the tiny kit all the strength she would need to survive without her mother.
I guess they want us to look after her.
Skykit conceded.
Exactly,
Brambleberry agreed.
And why would they leave her with us if they thought we were bad, or that bad things were going to happen?
Frogkit flexed his claws.
Can we go see where they're buried anyway?
No, Crookedjaw nosed them toward the nursery.
Shimmerpelt and Lakeshine will be wondering where you are,
Skykit sniffed.
Shimmerpelt's always too busy feeding Leopard Kit.
Brambleberry smoothed the kit's ruffled fur with her tail tip.
Why don't you take your mother some wet moss?
She suggested.
Feeding Leopard Kit will make her thirsty. She'll be so proud of you for being helpful to Bright Skies Kit.
Sky Kit's eyes brightened.
Okay.
She dashed away toward the reed bed.
Don't fall in,
Crookedjaw warned as Frog Kit hurtled after her. He turned back to Brambleberry, hesitating.
Are you sure it wasn't an omen?
I'm sure.
Crookedjaw narrowed his eyes.
How can you tell what's an omen and what isn't?
An omen feels different,
Brambleberry told him.
Can omens change things, or do they just tell you what's going to happen?
He knew Brambleberry would understand that he wasn't just talking about the kit's gossip. Brambleberry met his gaze.
Sometimes they tell you what's already happening.
So that you can change it?
So that you're prepared for it.
Frustration clawed at Crookedjaw's belly. She wasn't giving anything away.
Why don't you just tell me about my omen, the one that worried you?
There's nothing to tell,
she answered softly.
You mean there wasn't an omen?
I mean it's up to you.
What's up to me?
Crookedjaw couldn't keep the growl from his voice.
The path you choose is in your paws,
Brambleberry meowed.
Only you can know your own heart, and that will decide whether you choose the right path or the wrong path.
My heart is as true and loyal as any RiverClan cat.
Good.
Let me prove it.
How?
Crookedjaw searched desperately for ideas.
I don't know. Let me help you gather herbs.
Perhaps if he spent time with her, he'd be able to persuade her he was good.
I've already asked Beetle Nose to help me.
Crookedjaw swished his tail.
Okay, he snapped. But don't blame me if I choose the wrong path. You're the medicine cat. You're supposed to help your clanmates, not make them suffer because you won't tell them everything.
Ears hot with fury, he stalked away. The first light of dawn was showing behind the willow tree. Beetle Nose padded from his den and greeted Brambleberry with a yawn.
I'm ready,
he muttered. He brightened as Hailstar ducked out of his den.
Can't you get Willow Breeze to help you?
He begged Brambleberry.
This is an apprentice's job, and she's the closest to an apprentice we've got.
Brambleberry scowled back.
Stop fussing and hurry up.
Beetlenose sighed and, casting a final rueful look at Hailstar, followed her out of camp.
Let all cats old enough to swim gather to hear my words,
the RiverClan leader padded to the center of the clearing. Crookedjaw frowned. What was the leader planning now? Whatever it was, he hoped it would cheer up the clan. The kits weren't the only ones who believed StarClan was punishing them. Dens rustled and paws scuffed the ground as his clanmates climbed from their nests and padded to hear what Hailstar wanted. Rippleclaw's fur was ruffled and unwashed. Piketooth sat askew, his whiskers crumpled. Even Shellheart's shoulders drooped. Oakheart squeezed next to Crookedjaw, his gaze bleary with sleep.
What's going on?
He sighed.
It's hardly dawn.
Hailstar turned slowly, eyeing his clan.
We took Sunning Rocks back and ThunderClan didn't even retaliate. Today we will take more of their territory.
More?
Crookedjaw looked past Hailstar to his father, who was sitting behind the RiverClan leader. He tried to read Shellheart's gaze, but it was clear and unblinking. Cedarpelt stepped forward.
Do we need more of their territory?
He asked.
We need the river, Hailstar countered. We should control both banks beyond Sunning Rocks, which includes the forest that runs along the far side of the river.
Alfur tipped his head.
You want to capture forest?
Hailstar nodded. Troutclaw shook his graying head.
What would RiverClan do with trees?
Rippleclaw answered the elder with a growl.
It means we'll be able to fish the river above Sunning Rocks without fear of attack.
Willowbreeze was looking puzzled.
ThunderClan would never attack us in the water,
she pointed out.
They're terrified of it.
Otter Splash padded forward, her kits trotting after her.
But what if they learned to swim?
She shooed them away with her tail.
It'd give them prey all year round. As long as they control that stretch of river, there's a chance they may learn to use it like we do.
Troutclaw snorted.
ThunderClan is more likely to learn how to fly.
Birdsong nodded.
RiverClan has never owned that piece of territory.
Patrolling it would be hard work,
Fallowtail added. Timberfur lashed his tail.
Are you scared of hard work?
Fallowtail flattened her ears.
Of course not.
It would show ThunderClan were strong,
Whitefang put in.
They wouldn't try taking Sunning Rocks again,
Piketooth growled.
They'd be too busy trying to hold on to what's left of their forest.
Then it's decided.
Hailstar flexed his claws. Whitefang circled the RiverClan leader, pelt bristling.
When do we attack?
Now!
Crookedjaw stared at Hailstar in astonishment. Whitefang's gaze shone with excitement. Rippleclaws, too. Timberfur clawed at the ground impatiently, but Cedarpelt watched through narrowed eyes. Fallowtail was frowning, and Alfur turned his head away, sighing.
Why isn't he satisfied with Sunning Rocks?
Crookedjaw didn't understand Hailstar's plan. How in the name of StarClan could they win a battle fought on ThunderClan's land? He'd seen the thick ferns and clawing brambles that choked the trees around Sunning Rocks. His thick pelt rippled as he imagined getting it tangled in a thorn bush. Oakheart's mew shook him from his thoughts.
Does Hailstar think a battle will cheer us up?
I guess he's got to try something,
Crookedjaw shrugged.
Even the kits have been worried about Bright Sky's death.
Out of the corner of his eye, he noticed Otter Splash whispering to her kits.
But a battle is risky, and we don't need more grief.
I want to be in the attack patrol,
Otter Splash's mew rang across the clearing. Shimmerpelt gasped.
What about your kits?
Will you look after them till I return?
Otter Splash dipped her head to her denmate.
Of course,
Shimmerpelt stuttered.
But what if you...
Otter Splash cut her off.
Timberfur takes that risk,
she answered sharply.
Why shouldn't I?
Hailstar padded across the clearing.
I'd be proud to have you fight beside me.
His eyes glowed as he surveyed the rest of his clan.
Timberfur, Rippleclaw, Shellheart, Piketooth, and Whitefang,
he nodded to each warrior.
You'll join us.
For once, Crookedjaw was relieved he hadn't been chosen.
An impressive patrol,
he commented. Oakheart sniffed.
They believe in this battle.
At least someone does.
Crookedjaw growled under his breath. He felt a flash of guilt.
Can I lead a border patrol on this side of the river?
He called to Hailstar.
We haven't checked the bridge or fence in days.
Hailstar was already leading his clanmates toward the reeds. He glanced back.
Okay,
he answered.
Take anyone you like.
Loudkit was chasing after Otter Splash.
When are you coming back?
He whimpered. She stopped and leaned down.
I told you,
she murmured softly. I'll be back before sunhigh.
Promise?
Otter Splash pressed her muzzle to Loudkit's head.
StarClan willing,
she breathed. Loudkit stared after her as Otter Splash followed the patrol out of camp.
Will StarClan want her like they wanted Bright Sky?
He whispered. Crookedjaw opened his mouth to reassure him, but Shimmerpelt had already darted forward and was sweeping him away with the soft swish of her tail. Crookedjaw skirted the two-leg bridge and headed away from the river into a line of willow trees. He glanced over his shoulder. Volclaw, Oakheart, Petaldust, Willow Breeze, and Graypool were following him through the straggly grass, ducking behind the slim gray trunks at the edge of the meadow.
I don't see why we couldn't hunt, Volclaw grumbled.
We're patrolling, not hunting,
Crookedjaw told him.
Just because you suggested the patrol doesn't make you clan leader,
Volclaw sniffed. Petaldust nudged her brother.
It does make him patrol leader, though,
she pointed out.
Shh!
Crookedjaw paused and glanced through the willow trees. The sun was lifting into the sky, and all around the meadow, two legs were beginning to stir from their pelt dens. The field was dotted with the brightly colored mounds. They rustled and flapped in the breeze.
Get down!
Crookedjaw warned, as a two-leg crawled out of his den and padded, coughing, up the field. A two-leg kit tottered out after him, carrying a bright yellow ball. It tossed the ball and stood watching as it rolled across the grass and bumped into another den.
We'd better get past here before they're all awake,
Oakheart whispered. Crookedjaw glanced at the knotted gray fence that bounded the field beyond the trees. They'd have to creep up through the willows and around the top of the field to reach the dog fence.
Come on.
He began to pad forward, tail down. Sunlight streamed through the shivering leaves and dappled the grass. Crookedjaw trod lightly, keeping one eye on the pelt dens. Suddenly a shadow flashed between them. Crookedjaw paused. The shadow flashed again, and with a jolt he recognized the shape. A cat, with shoulders and tail that were familiar.
Maple Shade?
He hadn't trained with her for a moon. Why was she here? Oakheart halted beside him and tasted the air.
What's up?
Can you see that cat?
Crookedjaw nodded to the gap between pelt dens, where Maple Shade's outline was showing clear as day.
What cat?
Oakheart frowned at him.
Do you think the two legs have started taking their kitty pets out with them?
It's not a kitty pet,
Crookedjaw whispered.
It's a warrior.
Oakheart twitched.
Where?
There.
Mapleshade returned his gaze, then flitted behind a pelt den as the two-legged kit toddled past.
I can't see anything.
What's holding us up?
Volclaw hissed from behind. Willowbreeze crept past him and stopped beside Crookedjaw.
Is anything wrong?
Crookedjaw shook his head.
I'm seeing things,
he joked. As he began to move off, Mapleshade appeared again, padding around the edge of the pelt den.
What is she doing?
He kept walking. His patrol was depending on him to get them away from these two legs and safely back to camp.
You definitely can't see any cats with the two legs?
He checked with Oakheart.
Definitely.
Oakheart flicked his tail over Crookedjaw's spine.
I think you should get Brambleberry to check your eyes when we get back,
he purred.
And I can tell Beetlenose he's missed two patrols. He's going to be spitting mad. He's picking mallow leaves while Hailstar's invading ThunderClan and we're stalking a dog and an invisible cat.
Wait!
Crookedjaw interrupted, his heart tightening. Mapleshade was nudging the yellow ball toward them.
Go away!
Panic flared in him.
The two legs will see us!
Oakheart bristled beside him.
Is the wind making that ball move?
His gaze was fixed on the slowly rolling ball.
No.
Crookedjaw stared pleadingly at Mapleshade as she tapped the ball closer. She held his gaze but did nothing to stop the ball from trickling within a reed length of the warriors.
Two-leg!
Willowbreeze's hiss snapped his attention from Mapleshade. The two-leg kit was running after the ball, mewling. Graypool stiffened, a growl rumbling in her throat.
It's heading straight for us.
Duck down, Crookedjaw ordered, and stay still. It won't see us through the long grass. It's just a kit.
The patrol crouched, fear sparking around them. Crookedjaw peered through the green stems. Mapleshade's eyes glittered as she rolled the ball closer. With a final push, she sent it spinning toward the edge of the meadow. The two-legged kit stumbled after it, paws outstretched. With a thump, the kit fell over and started to wail. A huge two-leg darted from a pelt den and raced toward the kit, yowling. It scooped it up and held it, its gaze drifting toward the ball and then the willow trees.
Star Clan, help us!
Willowbreeze's hiss barely made it through her gritted teeth. The two-leg let out a yelp of surprise.
It's seen us!
Oakheart growled.
Hide!
Crookedjaw backed deeper into the long grass. He darted behind a trunk and held his breath as the two-leg put down its kit and headed into the willows. The two-leg kit was pointing straight at them. Volclaw darted behind a fern. Petaldust crouched beside him. Graypool flattened herself beneath an arching strand of bramble and Oakheart ducked behind a rock. Crookedjaw scanned the trees. Where was Willowbreeze? The two-leg was wading through the long grass now, ducking under a low branch.
Willowbreeze!
Crookedjaw's heart lurched as he spotted her backed against the gray knotted fence where it extended into the trees. The two-leg was leaning down toward her. With a grunt, it reached out with one pink hairless paw and grabbed her scruff. Crookedjaw swallowed back a cry of rage and fear and watched helplessly as the two-leg carried Willowbreeze back toward its pelt den. Its kit followed, yelping happily. Oakheart was beside Crookedjaw in an instant.
What happens now?
Crookedjaw stared at Willowbreeze, her paws churning the air as she dangled in the two-leg's grip.
We've got to rescue her.
How?
Volclaw stared at him, eyes blazing.
Why did you bring us here, you fish brain?
Petaldust leaped from her hiding place and circled her clanmates.
What are we going to do?
We've got to get out of here before they find the rest of us,
Volclaw hissed. Crookedjaw noticed Greypool staring after her sister in horror.
We'll rescue her, I promise.
Not now, though,
Oakheart nodded to the two legs who were crowding to see their catch. Some of them turned and pointed to the willow trees. Crookedjaw straightened up.
Let's get back to camp and organize a rescue patrol. We'll take the quickest route. Just make sure no one slows down enough to get caught as well.
He raced out of the trees and pelted across the meadow. The two legs stared in surprise as the patrol streamed past them.
Willow Breeze!
Crookedjaw yowled to her as he passed.
Don't fight them! Stay calm! I'll come back to rescue you!
He pounded into the marshes, twisting his ears to make sure he could hear his patrol at his heels. Weaving among the tussocks of spiky grass, he hurtled toward camp. He raced through the entrance so fast that reeds whipped his back.
They've got Willow Breeze!
The words froze on his tongue. The clearing was littered with injured cats. Otter Splash lay panting, her ear torn, her pelt clumped with blood. Her kits pressed against her, wailing with fear as Brambleberry draped cobwebs over her wounds. White Fang crouched beside her, his muzzle bleeding, while Piketooth limped back and forth, growling under his breath. Hailstar sat huddled in conversation with Shellheart, Timberfur, and Rippleclaw. Crookedjaw stared in dismay.
They lost the battle.
But what about Willow Breeze? He had to get her back.
Star Clan, help me.
Chapter 24 Petaldust and Greypool skidded to a halt behind Crookedjaw.
They lost,
Petaldust gasped. Volclaw stopped beside them.
What happened?
We'll worry about that later,
Crookedjaw raced toward Hailstar.
Two legs took Willow Breeze.
Shellheart looked up, his eyes dark. Hailstar's pelt bushed up. Timberfur flexed his blood-stained claws.
Where? When?
Rippleclaw leaned forward.
In the pelt den field, just now.
Did they hurt her?
Hailstar demanded. Crookedjaw shook his head.
They just carried her to their den.
They didn't harm her at all?
Hailstar pressed.
Did they seem angry?
Crookedjaw frowned. What difference did that make? They'd taken her. She'd be terrified and alone. Hailstar sighed.
This has been a bad day,
he called to Brambleberry.
How's Otter Splash?
Brambleberry peeled another cobweb from the wad beside her.
No deep wounds,
she reported.
She'll be okay.
Timberfur shrugged. The brambles did more damage than ThunderClan. Rippleclaw's pelt was smeared with blood.
They knew what they were doing when they drove us deeper into the forest.
Crookedjaw leaned forward.
What about Willow Breeze?
Hailstar shifted his paws.
From what you say, it seems like the two legs don't want to hurt her. She'll be okay until tomorrow. We'll send a rescue party then.
Tomorrow might be too late. What if they leave in the night and take her with them?
Don't you care? Shellheart ran his tail down Crookedjaw's spine.
We've taken quite a beating today, he explained.
Crookedjaw ducked away. Fallowtail pounded toward them.
Greypool says Willow Breeze has been taken.
Her blue eyes darted frantically from one warrior to another.
We have to save her.
We'll rescue her tomorrow, Hailstar meowed gently, once we've recovered from our wounds.
You're leaving her there?
Fallowtail stared at him.
Is it because she's half Wind Clan?
Hailstar shook his head.
That has nothing to do with it.
Really?
Fallowtail curled her lip.
You gave her up easily last time. Are you giving her up again?
You gave her up last time, Hailstar corrected.
And you let me!
I rescued her from Wind Clan, Hailstar reminded her.
You just wanted to win your clan's respect,
Fallowtail hissed. Hailstar's eyes glittered.
I wanted your kits to be with their true clan.
Timberfur stood and nudged Fallowtail away.
Hailstar will rescue her.
He steered her toward the clearing. Crookedjaw followed.
She'll be okay,
he nodded to Timberfur.
I'll look after her.
As Timberfur returned to Hailstar and Shellheart, Crookedjaw felt Fallowtail tremble beside him.
You have to save her.
Her blue eyes were clouded with fear.
I can't lose her again.
Greypool joined them.
We can't leave her there,
she agreed. She leaned against her mother.
Who knows what the two legs will do with her?
Crookedjaw nodded.
I'll rescue her,
he promised.
Now?
Greypool prompted.
After dark.
Crookedjaw was already planning his mission. He'd never get past the two legs while it was light, but they slept at night. He'd be able to find Willow Breeze in the dark by following her scent.
Can I come?
Graypole asked. Fallowtail bristled.
No!
Crooked Jaw gazed sympathetically at the gray warrior.
You stay with Fallowtail, he ordered. I can do this alone.
Why had Mapleshade pulled such a stupid trick? Did she hate Willow Breeze that much? Where was her loyalty to the clan? The day dragged on. As the sun slowly eased toward the horizon, Crooked Jaw's heart seemed to beat his chest hollow. Fallowtail paced along the edge of the reeds, muttering to herself while Graypool trotted after her. Brambleberry moved from injured warrior to injured warrior, treating wounds while the kits raced around the clearing, acting out the battle.
It's your turn to be ThunderClan,
Sunkit poked Frogkit with her paw.
I don't want to be stinky ThunderClan,
Frogkit growled. Owlfur and Cedarpelt had restocked the freshkill pile, but Crookedjaw wasn't hungry. As the river slid past, the air pressed hot against his pelt. Crookedjaw longed for a breeze. He glanced at the horizon, hoping for clouds to signal a change in the weather. But the sky was clear, blossoming stars as it darkened around a pale half-moon. Brambleberry got to her paws. It was time for her meeting at the Moonstone with the medicine cats from the other clans. Crookedjaw watched her head out of the camp, wondering how Goosefeather would welcome her after today's battle. It was time he left, too.
Aren't you eating?
Shellheart called as Crookedjaw padded past the freshkill pile.
Later, Crookedjaw headed for the entrance. I want to swim first, he mumbled. It's hot.
He ducked through the entrance and hurried along the grassy path.
I know where you're going,
Brambleberry's mew surprised him. She bounded down the bank and blocked his path.
How?
The medicine cat's eyes were wild, as though something had startled her.
Are you okay?
Crookedjaw shifted his paws. What was wrong with her? Brambleberry ignored his question.
You're going to get Willow Breeze,
she circled him, tail flicking.
Someone has to.
Yes, yes,
she agreed distractedly.
And that someone must be you. You must do it. It is part of your destiny.
Crookedjaw pricked his ears.
My destiny?
That must be why Mapleshade had been in the field.
What do you know about my destiny?
I know what I need to know. This is it. This is part of it.
Brambleberry paused and stared at him.
You're going to rescue Willow Breeze? Is that the path you're choosing?
Is that the path I should choose?
Crookedjaw's belly twisted at the alternative to let Willow Breeze stay with the two legs.
You know your own heart.
Brambleberry started pacing around him again.
I just hope StarClan is right.
Right about what?
Before he had finished speaking, Brambleberry darted back up the bank and disappeared into shadow. Crookedjaw swallowed.
Am I doing the right thing?
He pushed away the thought.
Of course I am. I can't abandon Willow Breeze. She's my clanmate.
He bounded up the bank, following Brambleberry's trail around the camp and into the marshes. The medicine cat must have moved fast because her scent was already growing stale. Crookedjaw headed down to the shore and followed the river upstream. The water looked black and deep beneath the stars. Behind him, the reeds rattled and the night heron swooped low across the water before soaring away. Crookedjaw veered away from the river and followed the shore past the first meadow, skirting the two-leg field right up to the bridge. He paused there, ducking down in its spiky shadow, catching his breath.
I'm not scared, he told himself.
He flexed his claws and peered through the willow trees. The pelt dens glowed with yellow light, throwing wildly misshapen shadows across the field as the two legs moved around inside. Pebbles shifted on the shore downstream. Crookedjaw froze. Something was stalking him. He crouched deeper into the shadow, tasting the air, scenting nothing but two-leg smells. Keeping low, he crept out from beneath the bridge and stalked forward. He ducked beneath the longest grass and crept along the shore. A shadow skirted the water. Crookedjaw flexed his claws and crouched down, ready to attack.
Crookedjaw? Graypool?
He straightened up.
What are you doing here?
She dashed forward to greet him.
It's spooky out here at night.
Her eyes were glittering.
I thought I told you to stay behind and look after Fallowtail.
Echo Mist's with her,
Graypool mewed.
Crooked Jaw's paws pricked with irritation. It's bad enough that I lost Willow Breeze, he growled. I don't want to lose you, too.
You won't.
Graypool's claws scraped the pebbles.
I'm here to help get her back.
Go home.
No.
Crooked Jaw hissed with frustration. Fine. Follow me. Graypool jumped up the bank into the willow trees.
What did I just say?
Crooked Jaw yanked her back down by her tail.
Follow me and stay close.
He padded quietly back to the bridge, leaped up onto the shadowy timbers, and tasted the air. The pelt dens were noisy with two legs mumbling and yowling. Graypool snorted.
Don't they ever go to sleep?
Crooked Jaw beckoned her on with a flick of his muzzle. At least they're inside, he whispered.
Let's see if we can figure out which one Willow Breeze is in.
Heart pounding, Crooked Jaw padded across the field, the soft grass stroking his belly fur. Graypool followed, her paw steps no more than a faint whisper on the grass. They halted beside the nearest pelt den and began sniffing the edge. Ducking down, Crooked Jaw caught a glimpse inside. It was chaotic, with brightly colored piles heaped everywhere and two legs squatting in the small space between. Countless scents bathed his nose, strong and startling.
Here,
Graypool hissed from the next pelt den.
I thought I told you to stay close.
He darted over to her and sniffed the edge of the den. Hope flared in his belly.
Willow Breeze.
Her scent was thickly laced with fear, but it was fresh. Suddenly a two-leg moved in the den. Its shadow engulfed them as it swept over the grass. Crooked Jaw froze, feeling Graypool trembling against him. Then the shadow swooped away as the two legs settled down.
We've got to go in there,
Graypool whispered shakily.
Yes.
Crooked Jaw poked his head under the stretched pelt and peered inside. It was more chaotic than the last den, the colorful piles bigger and brighter.
Good.
They'd be able to hide easily. He squeezed under the pelt and crouched behind a heap of two-leg clutter. Graypool slid in after him. Her breath was fast, her hackles high.
I won't let them catch you,
Crooked Jaw promised. He nosed his way around the edge of the den, squeezing through the narrow channel between the clutter and the den wall. The two legs were chattering and hooting, crouched around something in the middle of the den. Crooked Jaw stretched up and peered over the nearest pile, his ears flat, eyes wide. The two legs were dangling a thread into a square brown nest. Familiar, pale tabby paws flapped frantically at the thread, trying to catch it as the two legs twitched it and pulled it out of reach.
I can see her,
Crooked Jaw dropped down and whispered in Graypool's ear.
They've got her in some sort of trap, and they're teasing her.
Graypool flexed her claws.
Is she okay? I think she's playing along,
Crooked Jaw guessed. Graypool opened her mouth.
I don't smell blood. They haven't harmed her, then.
Crooked Jaw felt a rush of relief.
Now we have to wait. Here?
Crooked Jaw nodded. Now that he had Willow Breeze in sight, he didn't want to lose her again. He flattened his belly against the floor. Graypool settled beside him.
It'll be okay,
he promised her. She swallowed and nodded. Crooked Jaw began to grow stiff as the two legs played with Willow Breeze. He glanced over the pile again and again, itching with frustration until suddenly the two legs started moving clumsily around the den, rummaging in the muddled pelts that were scattered on the floor. Crooked Jaw tensed.
Look out!
Two-leg paws plunged into the heap they were sheltering behind. He ducked under the edge, out into the field, dragging Graypool after him.
That was close.
They crouched in the grass. The earthy scent of it soothed Crooked Jaw's jangled nerves. The light disappeared from the pelt den. Murmuring and rustling, the two legs gradually settled down.
Can we go back in?
Graypool's round eyes reflected the moon.
Let's wait a bit longer, Crooked Jaw whispered, until they're asleep.
On the other side of the willow trees, the river glided past, rolling pebbles along the shore, and an owl screeched far away. One by one, the pelt dens grew dark and silent.
Now.
Crooked Jaw slid under the stretched pelt once more. Ears pricked, he listened for movement. The two legs were still, lying under pelts at the far side of the den.
He sensed, rather than saw, Graypool beside him as he crept over a heap of pelts and padded across the den. He could just make out the brown trap near the two legs' hind paws. Fur swished inside it. Claws scrabbled quietly against its walls.
"She's trying to get out."
Crookedjaw darted toward it, hissing.
"We're here, Willowbreeze. We've come to get you."
A low purr of relief sounded inside the box.
"I can't get the flaps open at the top."
Crookedjaw reached up and saw the top of the trap was folded, flap over flap. He tugged at one, but it wouldn't shift.
"Let me help."
Graypool stretched up beside him and hooked her claws under a flap. Together they tugged, but the strange hard substance wouldn't give.
"Push,"
Crookedjaw hissed to Willowbreeze.
"I am,"
she snapped back.
"Together,"
Crookedjaw gave a fierce heave. The trap rocked wildly and tumbled over onto its side. Graypool squawked as it fell on top of her. The two legs sat up, yelping, as Graypool struggled to escape. Crookedjaw whipped his head around. The two legs were flailing in the dark. They hadn't spotted the extra cats yet, but it wouldn't be long. Panic surging inside him, Crookedjaw turned back to the trap. A gap had opened between the flaps. Willowbreeze's paws were stretching through.
"Pull!"
he yelled to Graypool. He didn't care if the two legs heard. They were thrashing around in their pelts, slapping the darkness with lumbering paws. As one brushed Crookedjaw's tail, he yanked desperately at the trap. It gave way, and Willowbreeze shot out like a rabbit from a foxhole. A light flashed over them. Crookedjaw caught the full glare and staggered, blinded. The two legs screeched.
"This way!"
Graypool pushed him forward. Crookedjaw hurtled headlong into a heap of pelts, his paws tangling with StarClan knew what. Terror clawed at him as he struggled free. Blurred shapes moved around him as he adjusted to the light. Willowbreeze was disappearing over the wall of pelts with Graypool on her tail. Crookedjaw shot after them, two legs shrieking behind him. He dived under the stretched pelt and out into the field. Willowbreeze was standing in the grass, staring at him.
"That was close."
Graypool grabbed her scruff and dragged her forward.
"Run, you fish brain!"
They pelted away through the dewy grass. Crookedjaw glanced over his shoulder. Two legs were bursting out of the dens all over the meadow, flashing lights and howling. Crookedjaw stretched his claws and dug them deeper with every stride, racing after his clanmates, with the blood roaring in his ears. Chapter 25.
Psst!
A hiss stopped Crookedjaw in his tracks. The reed bed was in view, pale under the moon, the two-legged pelt dens far behind. Willowbreeze scrambled to a halt and turned.
"What's wrong?"
Crookedjaw whipped his head around, tasting the air.
"Psst!"
A cat was signaling from the riverbank. Straining to see in the light of the half-moon, Crookedjaw spotted an orange and white pelt.
"Go on without me," he called to Willowbreeze. "I want to check something out."
Graypool had doubled back and was pacing around her sister.
"What's the holdup?"
"Crookedjaw's seen something."
Willowbreeze gazed at him curiously.
"Nothing important," he assured them. "Get back to camp. Fallowtail will be waiting."
Graypool frowned.
"Are you sure you don't need help?"
Crookedjaw flicked his tail impatiently.
"Just get Willowbreeze safely back. She's gone through a lot in one day."
Graypool nodded and stared her sister down the path.
"What do you want, Maple Shade?"
Crookedjaw padded angrily toward the clump of sedge she was hiding behind.
"Haven't you caused enough trouble?"
The she-cat flew at him, spitting. Shocked, Crookedjaw rolled onto his back and heaved her off with a sharp kick of his hind legs. Scrambling to his paws, he faced her, bristling. Her eyes blazed.
"You mouse brain," she snarled. "What?"
He couldn't believe his ears.
"You betray us to the two legs and then you're angry?"
"I was testing you, idiot."
A sneer curled her lip.
"I knew you were weak. I knew you wouldn't keep your promise. When your mate was stolen, you should have left her."
"She's not my mate."
"She will be."
Mapleshade stalked around him.
"I can see it in the way you look at her."
Crookedjaw growled.
"So what?"
"So what?"
Mapleshade echoed with a sneer.
"If she can't keep herself safe, then she's of no use to you. Your loyalty should be to your clan, not her."
Your clanmates are lying injured in camp, yet you sneak off and risk your life to save a warrior who can't even outrun a two-leg. She should be ashamed that she caused so much trouble. You should be ashamed that you deserted your clan on a fish-brained mission. Did Hailstar say you could go?
She didn't wait for an answer.
No. He told you to wait. Your disloyalty makes me sick. Cats who betray their clan should be banished. They should live as rogues and loners because that's all they are.
Hissing, she reared and slashed at Crookedjaw's muzzle with both paws. He knocked her away, suddenly aware that he was bigger than her and stronger.
Who are you?
He swiped at her, his paw catching her cheek and sending her tumbling to the ground. He was on her in an instant, digging his claws into her shoulders and pinning her down.
No StarClan warrior would turn on its clanmate. You mentored me and now you attack me?
Mapleshade went limp in his grip. Crookedjaw recoiled, suddenly afraid he had hurt her. The she-cat struggled to her paws, shrinking into a huddled crouch. She looked elderly and frail. Guilt seared Crookedjaw. Her blood was wet on his claws. Beating an old cat like that was no measure of strength. Groaning with the effort, Mapleshade lifted her muzzle.
I saw greatness in you the moment you were born, she croaked. You don't remember the storm, but I saw it. I saw how the skies heaved and roared at your birth.
She dropped onto her belly, panting.
You have a wonderful destiny, Crookedjaw. You're not just going to be the greatest leader of your clan. You're going to be the greatest leader of any clan.
She stopped to catch her breath.
But you have to keep your promise to me.
He crouched beside her, pity sweeping over him.
Of course I will. You'll have to make sacrifices, she warned. Your life is not your own. It belongs to your clan. Don't be distracted from all the wonderful things you can achieve. The greatest leader of any clan?
Excitement flashed through Crookedjaw as Mapleshade went on.
And you will achieve so much, as long as you have me to guide you.
She seemed to be gaining strength with each word.
I have chosen to help you. No one else, just you. Never forget that the clan is greater than its cats. Even if you sacrifice every cat who ever loved you, it will be no more than shedding raindrops from your fur, because even if they go, the clan will still be there and relying on you. Do you agree?
She lifted her gaze to meet his. It sparked with hope.
Sacrifice every cat who loved me?
Crookedjaw frowned.
Why would I have to?
But why?
He started to argue, but Shadow was swallowing Mapleshade as a cloud swept across the moon. Fat raindrops splashed on Crookedjaw's pelt. Wind tugged the branches above his head.
Don't go yet,
he begged.
Tell me more.
With a jab of disappointment, he found himself staring at bare earth. She had gone. He straightened up and stared across the marsh. The reeds beside the camp were rattling as the rain hardened.
I'm going to be the greatest leader any clan has ever known.
The words sang in Crookedjaw's heart. He broke into a run, heading for home. Strength pulsed in his paws. He'd saved Willow Breeze from Two Legs. He'd been chosen by StarClan.
I can do anything,